for 1,000 souls.
What will I not do to obtain his soul?
Consummatum est. This bill is ended, and Faustus hath bequeathed his soul to Lucifer. Here Mephistopheles received this scroll, a deed of gift of body and of soul, but yet conditionally that thou perform all articles prescribed between us both.
Faustus, I swear by hell and Lucifer to effect all promises between us made. Then hear me read them. On these conditions following, that Mephistopheles shall be his servant and at his command, and bring him whatsoever he desires at all times, and in what form or shape soever he please. I, John Faustus of Wittenberg, doctor by these presents to give both body and soul to Lucifer and his minister Mephistopheles.
See, I went to the big guys for the money. I was ready to prostitute myself in the manner in which I talk about it. But what happened was they said, come back when you're 40, son. And so I had to go out.
The soul is what makes us us, the soul of America.
Run the risk of deciding whether or not you're going to prostitute yourself to give the answer you know they want to hear in order to get funded to run for that office.
I believe we're in a battle for the soul of this nation. I still believe that to be true.
Implicit in the system is corruption, when in fact, whether or not you can run for public office, and it costs a great deal of money to run for the United States Senate, even from a small state like Delaware, you have to go to those people who have money, and they always want something.
Equality and democracy are under assault. We do ourselves no favor to pretend otherwise.
Since it's clear that you're not corrupt and you got elected, why should people think that the system produces corrupt results when there you are?
Well, I'm not sure you should assume I'm not corrupt, but I'm thank you for that, though.
That's who we are. That's what we stand for. That's what we believe.
The only way you can raise any money to get to run for public office is to go to vested interest groups. Then, in fact, you're put in the position that you have to begin to wonder whether or not you prostitute the ideas that you have about government in order to get the money to begin to run.
That's what we stand for. That's what we believe. And that's precisely what we're doing.
Well, if you were to set out to create a country in which you would have one man, one vote, free speech guaranteed to everybody, and then you'd have candidacies in which one side would be able to spend $22 million and the other side $500,000, you'd realize that that kind of democracy was a hoax. Nobody would even argue about it.
But democracy.
You run the risk in limiting the amount that can be spent of continuing the tyranny of the incumbent. For example, I'm on this show for one reason. I'm an incumbent United States Senator. Were this an election year, this would be allegedly votes for me back home. A challenger of mine would have to pay a great deal of money to get this kind of TV time. We have a lot going for us when we're incumbents, and we use it.
History tells us the blind loyalty to a single leader and a willingness to engage in political violence is fatal to democracy.
Well, I'm not sure you should assume I'm not corrupt, but I'm thank you for that, though.
That's our soul. That's who we truly are. And that's who we must always be.
Faustus hath bequeathed his soul to Lucifer.
A promise to be kept. There's nothing more important, nothing more sacred. And we're only just beginning.
Looks like a dystopian movie trailer in which the dead president is being played by a hologram. The whole vibe was hilariously creepy.
Very cynical attempt to fill our heads with stupid.
Imagery there was almost satanic with that blood red lighting and the two Marines behind him. It was just insane. Look, this was a garbage speech by a garbage president.
A strange and wildly inappropriate setting, the unusual weird red lighting.
It was ominous. There was a blood red background. He stood in darkness, claiming that he stands for light.
The whole speech was dark. The words were dark. The setting was dark. I really looked at it and I thought, my gosh, who wrote this and came up with the venue? Satan?
Why, there's enough for 1,000 souls.
What will I not do to obtain his soul?